These events especially affect girls and young women. Your hamburger comes with a dose of misogyny. Popular culture is flooded with references to sexy cows, sexy pigs, sexy chickens, sexy fishes, who all just want to have fun.
It's simple. You just have to know the anatomy of a turkey, and it's got over here just the tiniest little stink hole, but it's big enough to get your hand right up inside it. Stuff the shit out of it. I cook it with all the giblets. The penises and the ginies. And now a lot of people like to baste their turkeys, but I use this. I lick like that and get into the little hiney-hiney hole. That's nice and good. I don't know what the hell that is, but I lick it anyway. Up and down. And then I like to dip that right on there.
I don't know why. I've been looking for Darth all day. I haven't been able to find it. Darth! Darth! Darth News! We're looking for you! I'm gonna find you, Darth! I got a good question to ask you, okay? I got a question. It's a would you rather question. Okay, would you rather, be a vegan for the rest of your life or only be able to eat meat? Yeah, that was kind of dumb, right? Yeah, that was kind of dumb. Let me ask another one. Okay, all right, Darth, would you rather kill your mom with your bare hands or rape your dad? Yeah, would you rather kill your mom or rape your dad? I know, it's pretty fucked up, right?
I don't know, Tina. I don't have an answer for you. Okay, you're always asking me these stupid questions that are impossible to answer. Why do you even think of, I don't even want to listen to your questions anymore. No, I'm done with you, okay? Because nothing you say is ever intelligent.
Oh, that's not true, Darth. You just made that shit up.
You know what? Let's just take a beat, okay? Let's just take a collective beat. It's not that kind of beat, but you know what I'm saying. Just chill the fuck out for 5 seconds. And let me, got something in my throat. Let me throw it back at you, okay? I'm gonna throw this back at you. See how you like it. Let's see what happens when the shoe's on the other size. When the foot's on the other shoe. Fuck, what is this saying?
Yeah. It's like when you smoke a lot of crack, you know, crack cocaine, and then you watch some furry porn.
You know, Applejack, that is not even close. No, it's not. Okay, Tina. I got a hard question for you, all right? It's kind of philosophical, in nature, if you will. It's kind of like what came first, the chicken or the egg? I mean, there's no right or wrong answer, so I guess there's really no right or wrong answer to this question. But what do you think? Can you please stop? Why are you? Tina, I'm not in the mood right now.
I'm in the mood, Darth, so stop being a little bitch and pucker up!
We're not having sex. Can you please just put your vagina away? There's really no, like, right or wrong answer, but I want to know what you believe is the right answer, okay? So what do you think's the right answer to this question? Do we, as human beings, or as even animals, do we eat to survive? Do we eat to live? Or do we live so we can eat to continue to survive? So what are we living for? Are we living for...
I don't know.
You know what I mean? It's food for thought. See what I did there? Yeah, just let that digest for a minute. Let it marinate. And then let me know how it tastes. What do you mean you don't get it? It's a very simple concept. Are we alive to eat food to keep living, or are we eating food to stay alive? You know what I mean? Like, you know what? I forgot. You didn't even go to school. You didn't even go to fucking first grade. Tina, you're the dumbest person in this room. Besides Applejack. Sorry, Applejack. You're the second dumbest person in this room. I would be the third dumbest, because there's only three of us in here.
Hey. You forgot about the Spirit Panda.
Totally forgot about you, bro. My bad. Say what's up to Spirit Panda. Anyway, No. I offered to take you to public school, but you said no. You said you wanted to be homeschooled, so I said fine. And you didn't do anything school-related the last 3 years, so... You basically are retarded. Yeah, that's what... You're a retarded unicorn.
Darth, you cannot say that word anymore.
Spirit Panda, I appreciate your input, brother, but nobody was fucking talking to you. You need to learn to wait your turn. Ain't that right? Ain't that right, you got? Yes, you know when it's your cue. Read the room, bro. Fuck, man. I'll stop. Oh, Darth, as is in heaven. Oh, hallowed Darth, thy name. Thy Darth them come. Thy Darth will be done. As on Darth, as is in Darth heaven. I mean, don't all clap at once. I don't want a pity clap. Don't give me a pity clap.
I love you.
Don't bullshit me.
I love you.
I love you too,
Maureen.
Shut up and sit down.
I had to do this. Sorry. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to a brand new episode of Darth News. Special edition. Well, you know, just admit it. You're a Nazi? Everybody knows. What do you mean? How does everybody... Because... Do me a favor. Go ahead and check your watch. Yeah, I know. You're not wearing a watch. That's because I want you to look at your skin color. What color is your skin? Don't give me that olive complexion bullshit. You are not olive. You are white. You are white, and you are a supremacist. And you are racist by nature. Racism is your birthright. It has been passed down to you through all of the racist white supremacy genes. Getting off topic. So today's video is about an animal rights hall of famer. Yes, apparently that is a real thing. There's a hall of fame for animal rights activists that are super activist-y or stuff like that. I don't fucking know. You know, they support, like, you know, the Black Cows Matter and stuff like that. Anyway. But this loved, loathed, and infamous feminist animal activist argues like a fucking child in front of the entire Oxford Union Society that eating meat is a colonialist, misogynistic, white supremacist something, I don't know, we're gonna get into it, and even claims that eating meat, brace yourself, is considered sexual assault, also known as a grape, without the G. You do the math. Or is it spelling? I don't know. I'm not so smart sometimes, but here's the deal. It's rape. She's saying that by eating meat, not specifying what kind of meat, just fucking meat. I could be eating lizard meat. I would never eat my pet lizard, though. I know. My pet iguana had cancer and died. It was so sad. I have a deep respect and love for reptiles. Well, not the Komodo dragons. I'm not fucking with those. I mean, I respect them enough to not go anywhere near them. Let's get back to it. So here's the thing. This ball of joy is arguing like a wackadoo in front of the entire fucking world, saying that eating meat means you're essentially committing an act of sexual assault. That's sort of, yeah, that's what she's getting at. Ladies and gentlemen, the scene that we are about to, watch will definitely kill a few brain cells, without a doubt. Without a doubt. But what I'm about to show you is in no way, shape, or form a scene from some shitty SNL Alec Baldwin skit. No. This is a scene from real fucking life. This is real life, people. This is not a joke. This is not satire. Not a parody. This is where we're at. Speaking of where we're at, where are the drugs at? No, you put them away yesterday.
No, you had them last, Darth. You.
Yes, we got done snorting all that cocaine, and then you fucking put it all into the bag, and you put the bag somewhere. So just go fucking find it so I can finish the show. Because you know I need my cocaine. I need my cocaine. Go fucking get it. I can't do this shit without my cocaine. So fucking get it.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, I remember where I put him. I put him right in front of me.
Hey, stop being so fucking lazy. All you do is eat and, snort lines? What does that mean?
All right, guys. This ain't The Onion, okay? This isn't the Babylon Bee. This isn't some fucking satire article on Tumblr. This isn't fucking Twitter. This is real fucking life, man. This is as real as it gets. And it's stressing me out. It shouldn't stress me out. I should just laugh at it, and I'm going to. But deep down, it scares me, because I'm worried that these people are going to get too much power. Fucking cow farts. And cow farts are going to melt the icebergs. Nah. Look. Please, all of you, remember this. If you remember anything from this episode, just remember this. Your vote today directly expresses and greatly showcases your undying allegiances to your party and to your leaders. And it shows your never-ending rejection and hatred towards white supremacists and the fascistic, patriarchal worldview that we are all slaves to. Well, only POCs can be slaves, but... So I just want you to know that you coming out tonight and giving me your vote of confidence by hitting that like button and subscribing is a direct message to your oppressors that you're sending them a direct message that you're not going to take this shit anymore. You're not going to put up with their racist views and their you know, what's it called? Yes, thank you. Institutionalized racism, you know, yeah, we are still oppressed as blacks in this world. I just, you know, like, I mean, I'm not black, but I'm tan-ish. Look, it's the middle of winter, so how about you just get off my dick about it, okay? Never mind, forget all that, okay? The point is, if you love animals, okay, not eating animals, but if you like, you know, if you love like petting animals, like especially the big scary ones, you know, like the grizzly bears. Oh, I love petting them. They're the best. Have you ever tried to milk a polar bear? You can. You can milk a polar bear. I swear to God, it's crazy. I know. Does it? I didn't drink the milk. I just milked them. I know. I'm pretty sure it was a polar bear. Could have been a seal. Or sea lion. It had teeth. I know that. I don't fucking know. What is a polar... Show me a picture of a polar bear, please. Look, if you love animals and when you go grocery shopping and you see the meat section, you get triggered and you wake up every morning going, fuck the patriarchy, down with the patriarchy, then hit that like button.
Hey, this is when you smoke the crack and you watch the furry porn.
But if... They're talking in my ear. Hold on. Just hold on a second. Do I have to say that? I'm going to get kicked off YouTube if I say it. I'm going to get kicked off. I can't say that on YouTube. That's racist. Oh. Okay. So I can say whatever I want about white people and it's not racist? Is it like hate speech? There's no such thing as hate speech. I'm pretty sure there is. Oh, you have the Constitution right there? Okay. No, I try. I mean, I don't have a Constitution in front of me, so I believe you. Look, Todd. Can we wrap this up? I gotta. Okay, I'll say it. But remember, any blowback is on you, Todd. Okay, fine. Okay. All right, Todd. Fine. Okay. All right. We'll get it. Okay. God, can you stop, Todd. Stop calling me. That's not fucking funny. Okay. The earbuds out. No more talking to me in the earpiece. Yeah, Todd, a lot of the times he'll feed me my lines when I forget what I'm talking about. He'll remind me. He's got the script on hand. Yeah. Believe it or not, this show is 100% to the script. I wrote a whole script. I spent 10 days typing this script up so I can make it nice and polished like a professional YouTuber should. Okay, so I'm supposed to tell you that, fuck. There's really no nice way or easy way to put this, you know? Yes, we're gonna get to the video. Yes, we're gonna watch the video. Just shut up. If you're white. Okay, look. Well, I got a lot of white friends. You know, I got like one white friend. So, like, obviously, I don't mean this, like, you know, literally, even though I'm supposed to mean it literally. Okay. Holy shit. I feel like I'm not allowed to say this, but apparently I'm allowed to because it's about white people. Look, man, if you're white, just do us all a favor. Yeah, die. Yeah, just die. Just fucking die. Just, I don't really care how you do it. Jump off a building, walk into traffic, you know, walk out into a very thin ice pond that's deep enough for you to drown in and get sucked away, like under the ice, like in the movies. And then you're like banging on the ice and you suffocate to death while like someone's looking at you through the snow, like, you know, and you just like fade to black and just drown. Or you could do it like the HBO show Euphoria and just, you know, do a bunch of, you know, oxys, roxys, Xannies, heroines, crack. You know, if you don't do a lot of drugs, I'm pretty sure you could OD on your first time. So no need to, like, you know, warm up or stretch. Just if you're white, I'm only speaking to white people. So if you're white, just, you know, just. I hope you're happy, Todd. I hope you're happy, Mr. Voice. You've been very quiet the last few months. I said you've been very quiet the last few months. Fucking. All right, so without further ado, let's go ahead and get into this ridiculous video. And as we watch it, I will be breaking it down, giving you my 2 cents, which isn't even worth 2 cents. It's not even worth the copper that it was made on. Look, thoughts aren't made of copper, but thoughts don't know that. Do-doom-doom. Okay, so for real, let's go ahead and watch this video. Applejack, hit it!
I believe we should move beyond all meat. The assumption that the best protein comes from corpses is a racist belief.
Wait, fuck! That's not an assumption. That is like biological scientific fact. Yeah, I know you can get plant protein. I know that. But it's not better than real protein. Oh, but Darth, it is real protein. Why don't you go eat your fucking plants then? Fucking bitch.
How do you know the animal would have picked you to feed off their corpse? 21st century animal eating requires our complicity in a new colonialism. These events especially affect girls and young women. Your hamburger comes with a dose of misogyny.
Oh my God, what the fuck? Okay, I've watched this video like 3 times and it gets me more mad every time I watch it. I'm getting more pissed now than the first time I watched it. The first time, I thought it was funny. The second time, I had to like pay attention. The third time, I'm terrified that They're gonna take away my burgers, man. If you take away my fucking burgers, I'm gonna murder you. And I will make you into my burger. You will be the meat. I will fucking eat you alive. I won't even cook you. I'll just fucking start cutting into you. That's gross. I would not do that, obviously. I just don't understand. These are the same people who are like, the science, 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 science. Wear your masks. Science. Oh, God. I cannot do a Fauci. Oh, that hurts the vocal cords. Science! Ah, fuck. This is the same bitch kneeling at the altar of wokeism and fascism and fucking mandates. This is the same activist who's activisting for all those other bullshit fucking things. You know what I'm saying? This is the same person who's yelling at you to listen to the science. Listen to the science. Just listen to the science. Don't you fucking, like, read science? Don't you know anything about science? Huh? Well, this woman who clearly cares... Did I misgender her? Is it a she-her? I want to go with woman. So this woman is the type of woman who yells at you to listen to the science and then doesn't even want to fucking take 2 seconds to look into the nutritional science. And yes, you can survive a very healthy, active, long life as a vegetarian. But vegans, oh no, their shelf life expectancy isn't very long. No. No, most of them end up regretting it. Most of them, not all of them. I know there's a few of you that are vegan. I know. You always remind me, I know. So I'm not mad at you. I'm just mad at the vegans that fucking yell at me, that yell at the world, that tell them that they're fucking sexist and they're racist and they're white supremacists. The fuck, man? Let's get back to it.
That the best protein comes from corpses is a racist belief.
I mean, what is she even saying? Really? Like, what the fuck is she saying? Protein from a corpse is a racist belief? What the... I disagree. Like, 100% disagree with that.
Your hamburger comes with a dose of misogyny.
Look, I'm a girl, right?
Popular culture is flooded with references to sexy cows, sexy pigs, sexy chickens, sexy fishes, who all just want to have fun.
Oh, my God. I just broke my... Okay, I'm gonna try to just like... I just wanna end this video, is what I wanna do. What is she talking about though, for real? Sexy cows? Sexy pigs? Sexy chickens? Sexy fishes? What? Am I missing something? Okay, because I've watched this 3 times now, and I don't know what the fuck she means when she's talking about sexy pigs.
Meat eating is also one of the ways gender-based structures of oppression are perpetuated.
What did she just say? Can we take that back really quick? Can we just take it back?
Meat eating is also one of the ways gender-based structures of oppression are perpetuated. Masculinity, a construct of the gender binary facing constant destabilization.
Okay. She's lost me. I don't know what she's going on about. I don't know what the fuck she's talking about. I got no idea what's happening. This is like the dictionary definition of psychobabble bullshit.
Feels always under threat, and eating animals is its protection racket. White supremacists weaponized it, eating meat, eggs, and dairy.
Pause it. Just like, pause. I can't. I just can't. I just can't with some people, you know what I mean? Like, you ever feel that way? You know, you just can't with someone, you're just like, I fucking hate you, and I just can't with you right now. Like, what the fuck, man? Like, what is she saying? Like, okay. I'm not trying to be dramatic, okay? But seriously, man. What the fucking fuckity fucking fuck is she saying? Do you know? Can somebody translate this into English for me, please? White supremacists weaponized eating meat. What are you talking about? Like, I want to know what the I want receipts. I want sources. Nobody weaponized eating meat. And if anybody weaponized food, it's the left. It's all of you fucking liberals. You weaponized soy. Yeah. You. You weaponized soy, and now you have a whole fucking army of soy boys. With tits. Congratulations. They're going to be the first to die in war.
And the baiting of liberal men as so-called soy boys are all part of the neo-Nazi message.
And speaking of soy boys, so I think what she's saying is that soy boys are a fictional right-wing construct that was designed by the far-right underground Nazi regimes, and they're used as dog whistles and secret messaging to all the white supremacists in the world. You know, thank God everybody's laughing at this bitch. Thank God everyone is... I have faith in humanity and in the future of our society and civilization because the audience was laughing at her.
All part of the neo-Nazi messaging.
They weren't laughing with her because she wasn't fucking laughing. She was like, take this seriously. I know you're fucking... Nah. The fact that the audience was not jiving with what she was jiving, it made me feel really good. Yeah. That's it.
All part of the neo-Nazi messaging. To say you care about animals is considered a sign of weakness in a world still committed to the gender binary.
Oh, God. Committed to the gender binary? Gender is binary. Okay? Gender, sex, it's binary. Your sexual orientation is fluid. But gender... Oh, this is going to piss off a few of you. I'm going to lose even more subs because I've been bleeding subs like a fucking sieve. I lost like 50 in like a day or some shit. Anyway, look. Yeah, there's two sexes. There's two genders. You can't and you won't ever change my mind. And if you believe that there's more than two, then, well, and don't give me that intersex bullshit. If you believe that there's more than two genders, two sexes, then you believe in make-believe, you believe in magic. You believe in something that's not based in reality. So you are technically crazy? Does that make you crazy? If you believe something that's not real, it makes you crazy, right? You're all fucking crazy. Like, you could be a guy, and you might think you're a girl, but you're still a guy, okay? You know, you might be a guy, and you're like, no, I don't have any gender because I'm pansexual. It's like, no, that just means you want to fuck everybody and everything. That's what that's... Moving on.
Messaging. To say you care about animals is considered a sign of weakness in a world still committed to the gender binary. Meat eaters like anti-abortionists have forgotten that one quality of non-existence is not having awareness about existence.
Wow, bravo. Brava, brava. Congratulations. In the same breath, this commie cunt bitch managed to shame meat eaters while in the same sentence promoting abortions. So she clearly cares more about baby cows than baby human beings. Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's some pretty sound logic. Can't argue with that. No, science? What's science? Science, that's just a bunch of patriarchal, racist, bigotry, bullshit that they just made up. so that way it would fit their, you know, their racist narrative. Yeah, math is racist. It sure is. You know what's not racist? Black people. Are you racist? You better take a hard look in the mirror, buddy. You better ask yourself, am I one of those KKK? 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 Shake that booty. Shake that booty. Give me a break of that KKK. Kit Kat bar. Give me a break. Give me a break. Give me a break of that KKK bar. Ha ha.
When all else fails, meat eaters assert that animals are not our equals.
Newsflash, animals are not our fucking equals. Far from it, in fact. We're not even fucking, not even close. We're not even in the same ballpark as a fucking, you know, a chimpanzee. But you know what is our equals? And what you should treat like equals? Other human beings, yeah, other people. Yeah, but you don't care about people. You care more about your fucking animals. Now, I'm not saying I don't care about animals, okay? I got a bunch of dogs. I love animals. I eat the ones that I eat. Fuck you. I don't go to McDonald's. I don't eat that shit. I'm not for factory farming, but I do eat meat. I eat a lot of it, actually. Yeah, and I love it. And when I'm eating it, I know that this animal is not a human being. And that fact alone puts my mind at ease that it's not a human being. Therefore, it's not my equal, okay?
I heard all your laughter. I know some of these must be new ideas, or you think they're fringe or whatever.
New ideas? No, not new, just really bad ideas. And fringe or whatever. Yeah, you're pretty fucking cringe. This whole thing you got going on is cringe. Your grandkids are probably watching this going, oh my God, Grandma, shut the fuck up! Look, you're cringy. Cringier than me. And not to mention, you're kind of fucking creepy also. This whole thing is giving me creep vibes. I'm getting creepy vibes. I don't like it. Not a fan. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know. I don't really want anything to do with your creepy fucking cunty cult, okay? You can keep your cunty cult to yourself. Nobody wants to join.
They're fringe or whatever. Our whiteness is part of the problem of meat eating.
Ooh, that's a bingo! You hear that, boys and girls? You hear that? Your whiteness is part of the problem of meat eating. Yeah, you're part of the problem, you fucking crackers. You're fucking... white people, I guess just saying you're white is enough of an insult these days. So if our whiteness is the problem with eating meat, you know, if that's the problem, then what say you about the, I don't know, the 3 billion Asians that all eat meat, or the 1.5 billion Indians, the Browns, or what about the billion Spanish people who eat meat, that carne asada, every fucking day? Huh? What about all the people in the Middle East who love that fucking, you know, that kebab and that chicken polo and yeah, you know what I'm saying? They eat that shit for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The whole world eats meat. Every race eats meat. And if we want to get real, like, real triggering for a second, if you look at the population of Earth from a global scale, white people are definitely in the fucking minority. Okay, we're the real minorities. Well, I'm not white, but I'm standing up for all the white people. And black people. And Asian. I'm standing up for everybody, okay? Stop treating us like we're different. Stop saying crazy shit. Stop spreading fucking insane rhetoric like eating meat is racist. Like white people are the problem. It doesn't even make... fuck you. And until next time, don't you dare forget to pull out. That is P-O-O fucking L. And as always, remember to like, share, subscribe, hit that bell. And if you could, this channel is completely demonetized. Yep. I do this for free. I just like rant at the camera free, because it's fun. And I got nothing else to do when I'm bored, so this is how I fill up that time. I mean, it takes a lot of work, but anyway, the point is, it's hard. It's not easy. I mean, it's hard. It's like fun, hard work. It's like... Okay, I guess what I'm saying is I enjoy making videos and shit, but I do it, you know, at the mercy of people that help me financially. So, if you want to support my channel, as little as $1 a month or, you know, like a one-time donation, you know, you can go to my Cash App, my Patreon, or you can go to my merch store and buy some merch. I'm shipping out a bunch of orders tomorrow morning, so if you put in an order the last 3 days, it's going out tomorrow, so good on you. No, but seriously, thanks for supporting the channel and making those orders. I do appreciate it. Especially you, Wendy. Thank you, Wendy. All right, I think that about wraps up this penis for tonight. I guess you take the condom off when you're done, so I wouldn't be wrapping it up. I'd be taking it off. Well, it looks like we're taking off this condom for tonight. I'm gonna go fuck off. Flush it down the toilet. I want to touch your nipples with my toes. Then I want to lick your butthole. And I want it to be freshly shaved like 2 days ago. So that way there's a little bit of a prickle. I love licking the prickles. It's like licking like a little prickly cactus. Oh my god, I love cactuses. Because cactuses, they're awesome. Because like, I did like a bunch of peyote once. Which is like a psychedelic you get from like a cactus. So I took like the cactus drugs. And I was tripping my balls off, right? And then there was like a baby cactus that was just sitting in a little pot. And it just grew life size. The fucking cactus grew up like, it got as tall as me. And then it grew some arms. And I was like, holy shit, that's fucking awesome. And then it grew some tits. And I was like, no, what? It started growing fucking boobies. This cactus. It's like a cactus lady. So then all of a sudden the cactus started growing like these really long bristles. Like needles, but it was the hair. And I was like, oh, this cactus is kind of fucking hot. But it still only had one leg, one torso, but like a fucking, like a mermaid, right? Like no butthole, no vagina. But then something happened. Something amazing. She told me, using her psychic powers, because she didn't have a mouth yet, but she was telling me with her telepathy that she wants to fuck me. And I said, but you need to have something to fuck, you know? And she said, all you have to do, Darth, is believe. So I closed my eyes and I believed. And boom, that bitch took 2 steps out of the pot and jumped on this dick. And I had to go to the hospital right after that because I found out that I was just, you know, bare-ass humping a baby cactus, and my friends were trying to, you know, get me to stop, and I just was having such a good time that I didn't realize I had completely ripped off the tip of my penis. But not here nor there. Time heals all wounds. Yeah, except for gunshot wounds. The fatal ones, yeah. You don't come back from that. Scared me for a second, you know what I mean? Like, thought I was gonna go off. Anyway, before I go, one last thank you to Crystal C. I don't want to say her last name, just in case people are weird. But Crystal, thank you so much for Spirit Panda. You're the best. Oh yeah, don't forget to stay Darth.